and move on to GCC. Yeah, I think one of the reasons why I remember now converting all the packages to BZIP2, not only to save space, but so that extracting them, I didn't have to find out which method of compression was used. They're all BZIP2, so they can all be extracted with XJ. So what does it say here? So it says unpack only the GCC core tarball. So it's just this file at the moment. And it says about running the test suite. As I say, I ran the test suite at this point during this chapter, even though the modern Linux from scratchers don't recommend it, just to see how the build was going and the results for GCC. I don't think it was this pass, I think it was pass two, were identical to some that were published, which we'll see in a little while. But I'm not going to do them now, A, because I know the build works okay, and B, it's just save some time. I think it's unnecessary, really. Okay, so cd gcc, and you see there's two compilers there. It's the later one we should be dealing with. Don't use the 2.95 if you're having a go at this. So make the a temporary build directory, configure the build. Okay, so that is configured and we can start the build and wait a while for this to complete. Okay, so let's finish compiling after just under 2 hours. So let's now install. And create this compatibility link to CC, and that's GCC done. So there's no information here about not removing the stuff we've just compiled, so let's do that now before we carry on. And move on to Linux headers.